It's time for English on the Go. So we're going to look at Kelsey's full clip where she talks to us about how in the past, her spending habits weren't so good and she wasn't really good at saving money. And we'll learn how that changed for her. Let's look.
Just wanna ignite ya.
Are you ready? Go!
I actually used to be terrible when it came to saving money. I would just spend money all the time because I thought, well, it doesn't matter because I'm going to get paid next week and I'll just make the money back. So anytime I got paid, I'd go shopping, and because I was living at home, I didn't have to pay rent or anything. I would just buy whatever I wanted. I'd eat all the food I wanted, and it was really fun until I moved out of home and I started having to pay rent, and then I just had to learn how to budget my money, and that was a really stressful experience because at the same time, I had to pay rent now, but I was still trying to live this lifestyle where I was buying all the clothes I wanted and eating all the food I was eating. And it wasn't until I actually had to go shopping one day and I didn't have any money to buy food and clothes. I had to pick one or the other, and I bought clothes and then I didn't have money for food. That's when I realized that I was in trouble. So I've learned to budget since then.
이야기 잘 들어보셨죠? 오늘의 핵심 어휘 보겠습니다. 어렵지 않은데요. 첫 번째로는 rent가 나왔고요. 집세나 방세, 임대료를 뜻합니다. 그리고 예산을 뜻하는 budget, 그리고 아까도 소개해드렸었지만 예산을 세우다, 예산을 짜다라는 동사로도 쓰일 수 있습니다. 간단하게 발음 연습해볼게요.
Let's practice our pronunciation starting with rent, rent, rent. And lastly, we have budget, budget. Budget. Perfect. Let's take a look at Kelsey's clip once again, but with English subtitles.
I actually used to be terrible when it came to saving money. I would just spend money all the time because I thought, well, it doesn't matter because I'm going to get paid next week and I'll just make the money back. So anytime I got paid, I'd go shopping, and because I was living at home, I didn't have to pay rent or anything. I would just buy whatever I wanted. I'd eat all the food I wanted, and it was really fun until I moved out of home and I started having to pay rent, and then I just had to learn how to budget my money, and that was a really stressful experience because at the same time, I had to pay rent now, but I was still trying to live this lifestyle where I was buying all the clothes I wanted and eating all the food I was eating. And it wasn't until I actually had to go shopping one day and I didn't have any money to buy food and clothes. I had to pick one or the other, and I bought clothes and then I didn't have money for food. That's when I realized that I was in trouble. So I've learned to budget since then.
Yeah, I think not having money for food will definitely teach you a great lesson in budgeting, right?
네, 뭔가 진짜로 옷보다 음식을 사러 갔는데 돈이 부족하다라고 생각하면 더 뭔가 확 와닿을 것 같습니다. 그런 경험을 캐시 씨가 실제로 하셨고 그 후로 좀 습관을 바꿨다고 해요.
All right.
자, 처음으로 돌아가서 문장 하나하나씩 보면서 공부해 볼까요?
Let's do it.
I actually used to be terrible when it came to saving money. I would just spend money all the time because I thought, well, it doesn't matter because I'm going to get paid next week and I'll just make the money back.
I actually used to be terrible when it came to saving money.
I used to be, 그 사이에 I actually used to be. 저는 사실 used to be terrible.
Terrible.
정말 못했었습니다. When it came to saving money. Mm-hmm. When it comes to 라고 그냥 굳어진 형태로 많이 외우실 텐데요. Mm-hmm. 과거에 대한 이야기를 할 때는 when it came to라고 바꿀 수 있습니다. Mm-hmm. 그래서 돈을 아끼는 데 있어서는 정말 형편없었어요. 물론 I actually used to be terrible at saving money.
Yes.
해도 똑같은 뜻이죠.
Yes, for sure. In that case, it would mean exactly the same. Mm-hmm. Let's find out more about her money spending habits. I would just spend money all the time because I thought
I would just spend money all the time. 저는 그냥 항상 돈을 쓰곤 했어요. Mm-hmm. I would라는 것은 과거에 반복적으로 하던 행동을 말합니다.
That's
그래서
right.
왜 돈을 그냥 막 썼냐면 이렇게 생각했기 때문이죠.
Mm-hmm. So she thought, what? Well, it doesn't matter because I'm going to get paid next week and I'll just make the money back.
네, 왜 it doesn't matter라고 생각했냐면 mm-hmm. 아, 상관없어. 지금 당장 돈이 모여있지 않아도 돈이 쌓이고 있지 않아도 상관이 mm-hmm. 없대요. 왜냐하면 because I'm going to get paid next week. Mm-hmm. 다음 주에 돈을 받을 거고 월급을 mm-hmm. 받을 거고 and I'll just make the money back. 물론 이 get paid next week 하고 make the money back 이 두 가지를 분리해서 생각할 수도 있지만 여기에서 켈시 씨가 말을 하는 느낌으로는 이게 이제 결국 같은 거예요.
Yeah, in this case it's the same because 네. she's getting paid so the money will she'll have more money,
그렇죠.
right? Even 지금, if she uses it all right now.
네. 밑에 번역에는 분리해서 그냥 둘 다 번역을 했습니다. 그런데 무슨 말이냐면 다음 주에 돈 받을 거고 I'll just make the money back. 그러니까 예를 들어 통장에 얼마가 있었어요. 그런데 그걸 다 써버렸어요. 그럼
yeah.
다음 주에 돈을 받으면 다시 그게 차겠죠.
Yeah, you get the usually when you get paid, it's the same amount as well. 네. So I think that's why she said get the money back.
맞아요. 그래서 make the money back.
Oh, make the money back.
그래서 다음 주에 돈 받아서 그만큼 또 벌 거니까 하나입니다. 여기서 연결된 겁니다. Mm-hmm. 그래서 상관이 없어라고 생각했대요.
What else did she used to think?
So anytime I got paid, I'd go shopping, and because I was living at home, I didn't have to pay rent or anything. I would just buy whatever I wanted. I'd eat all the food I wanted.
So anytime I got paid, I'd go shopping.
그래서 anytime I got paid, 저는 돈을 받을 때마다 anytime이라고 하는 거는 또 이런 의미로는 every time으로 바꿔도 괜찮을 것
yes.
같습니다. 네, mm-hmm. every time 아니면 each time.
Each time.
그래서
anytime.
네, 돈을 받을 때마다 I would go shopping.
Shopping.
쇼핑을 하러 가곤 했어요. 물론 I would를 그냥 I'd라고 줄여서 발음하긴
yes.
했습니다.
I'd go. I'd go.
I'd go shopping. Hmm.
Next, she says, and because I was living at home, I didn't have to pay rent or anything.
이 문장은 좀 어색하게 느낄 수도 있을 것 같아요. I mean, most people live at home.
Right, but when we say live at home, for us, at least, we mean with our parents.
맞아요. 그래서 because I was living at home, 이거를 그냥 저는 집에서 살고 있었기 때문에 I was living in my house, not in my friend's house, 이런 느낌이 아니고
no.
At home은 진짜로 in my parents',
parents
house,
home.
Or parents' home,
yeah.
in my parents' place. 부모님 집이라고 이해를 하셔야 정확하게 이해가 된 겁니다.
그래서, I never thought about that.
Yeah.
We never usually say in my parents' home, it's just I was living at home.
Yeah, so you can say I'm back at home.
At home, which means you're at your parents' house.
네, 네.
워낙, That's weird.
워낙 서양 같은 경우에는 한 20대만 돼도 uh-huh. 독립하는 게 흔하다 보니까
right.
at home 하고 그냥 my proper place, my own
right.
place 이런 구분이 좀 있는 것 같아요.
Huh.
그래서
I didn't even know and I speak English.
예. 아무튼 부모님 집이라는 의미로 썼지만 그냥 uh-huh. at home 했다는 거고요.
Uh-huh.
그래서 I didn't have to pay
rent. Rent
mm-hmm. or anything,
or anything, yeah.
렌트 같은 거, 월세 같은 거를,
you know, utilities, those kind of things. Basically,
네.
she didn't have to spend money for living.
그렇죠. Utilities, 공과금, 그러니까 전기라든지 수도라든지 mm-hmm. 이런 거 돈을 낼 필요가 없었죠.
Mm-hmm.
집세, 방세, 임대료가 다시 한번
rent입니다.
Rent.
Rent.
Okay.
So since she didn't have to pay rent, I would just buy whatever I wanted. I'd eat all the food I wanted.
네. I would just buy whatever I wanted. Mm-hmm. 여기서 계속해서 I would 반복되고 있습니다.
That's right.
원하는 건 뭐든지 사곤 했고
mm-hmm.
I'd eat라고 했지만 원래는 I would eat. 그래서 I would eat all the food I wanted. 먹고 싶은 모든 음식, 원하는 모든 음식도 먹곤 했습니다. 그러니까 돈을 아끼진 않았어요.
Yeah, so she didn't save money. She just spent it all.
Mm-hmm.
Let's find out what else she has to say.
And it was really fun until I moved out of home and I started having to pay rent. And then I just had to learn how to budget my money.
And it was really fun until I moved out of home and I started having to pay rent.
영어에서 이렇게 이야기를 하다가 until이 주는 그 효과가 굉장히 커요.
Uh-huh.
It was really fun. 정말 재밌었어요. 그런 생활 자체가. Uh-huh.
버는, until
네, 버는 만큼 막 쓰는 거죠. 근데 uh-huh. until 그러다가 상황이 반전이 됩니다. 역전이 됩니다.
Well, 그래서 you said a lot.
Yeah.
It was great until,
until
something happened.
Yeah, my day was great until you came along. 이라든지
oh,
유머로만
I'm sorry.
I wasn't saying that to you.
okay.
But a lot of people
My mood was great until you said that.
이렇게 쓰시면 됩니다. 잘 나가고 있었는데 이런 일이 생겼다. So until I moved out of home.
Mm-hmm.
여기도 home이라는 말이 whose home?
Her parents' home.
부모님 집에서 이제 독립을 하는 거를 여기서 mm-hmm. moved out of home이라고 했습니다.
Mm-hmm.
그래서 독립해서 나가서 I started having to pay rent. 월세를 내야 하기 시작했을 때까지 재밌었다. 그러니까 재밌다가 그렇게 되니까 상황이 달라졌다는 이야기예요.
Yes. So what was different now? She says. And then I just had to learn how to budget my money.
네, 예산 또는 예산을 세우다.
Budget. Budget.
예문 하나 볼까요?
Mm-hmm. For example, you could say we are working on a very tight budget.
네, 이번에는 명사로 쓰인 예문을 한번 준비해 봤어요.
Yes.
그리고 working on a tight budget 아니면 a very tight budget mm-hmm. 이렇게도 쓸 수 있고 working with 했어요.
네. Working with. Because if you say working on, it could mean that you're making a tight budget
있죠.
as well.
맞아요.
So if you say working with, you know there's already a budget and you don't have much money to spend for that thing.
네, 둘 다 쓸 수 있는데 on 같은 경우에는 또 두 가지로 의미가 갈릴 수 있어서 with라고 쓰셔도 괜찮습니다. 그래서 아무튼 예산이 아주 빠듯해요. 빠듯한 예산을 가지고 지금 뭔가 업무를 하고 있어요. 라는 의미로 명사로 쓰인 예문이었고요. 다시 돌아가서 and then I just had to learn how to budget my money. 제 돈을 어떻게 예산을 짜서 쓸지를 배워야 했대요.
Let's look at the next part.
And that was a really stressful experience because at the same time, I had to pay rent now, but I was still trying to live this lifestyle where I was buying all the clothes I wanted and eating all the food I was eating. And it wasn't until I actually had to go shopping one day and I didn't have any money to buy food and clothes.
And that was a really stressful experience because at the same time, I had to pay rent now.
네, and that was a really stressful experience. 스트레스를 정말 많이 받는 경험이었대요. 왜냐하면 at the same time, 사실 여기서 말하는 at the same time은 이제 뒤쪽하고 연결이 되는 건데
yeah, we'll find out later.
동시에 I had to pay rent now. 이제 월세도 내야 했거든요. 근데 무엇과 동시에?
She says, she had to pay rent now. And she says, but I still tried to live this lifestyle where I was buying all the clothes I wanted and eating all the food I was eating.
문장이 굉장히 길어지긴 했지만 구조는 잘 보입니다. 그러니까 월세도 내야 했지만 갑자기 부모님 집에서 나와서 다른 곳에 혼자 사니까. 그런데 동시에 또 여전히 뭘 하고 싶었냐면 I still try to live this lifestyle. 이런 라이프스타일, 생활 방식을 계속해서 유지하고 싶었던 거예요. 어떤 생활 방식이냐면 where, 그 생활 방식 속으로 들어가 보면, 장소처럼 들어가 보면 I was buying all the clothes I wanted. 원하는 옷은 다 사고 사고 있었고 eating all the food I was eating 여기서 제가 먹고 사실은 이제 all the food I wanted 의미인데요.
Yeah.
원래 이제 먹던 음식 있잖아요.
Yeah, so whatever she was eating before, like spending 예전에. all the money on food before.
Before를 넣으면 더 정확할 수 있겠네요.
Yeah.
그래서 예전에 먹던 음식 그대로 먹으려고 지금 월세로 돈이 이만큼 나가는데 옷도 똑같이 사고 음식도 똑같이 먹는 생활을 계속 살고 싶었으니까 동시에 이래서 스트레스를 받았대요. 그리고
And next she says, and it wasn't until I actually had to go shopping one day and I didn't have any money to buy food and clothes.
네, 여기가 중요한 것 같습니다. 마지막에 그 and clothes. 실제로 켈시 씨도 이렇게 발음을 했고요. It wasn't until 뭐뭐 하기 전까지는 아니었다. 그러니까 그때가 되어서야 깨달았다라는 의미인데요. I actually had to go shopping one day. 어느 날 쇼핑하러 갔는데 and I didn't have any money to buy. 그러니까 살 돈이 전혀 없었어요. Food and clothes.
and clothes.
음식도 사고 옷도 살 돈은 없었어요.
So she couldn't buy them both, but she could buy one. Yeah. We'll know after we find out what she says next, right?
I had to pick one or the other, and I bought clothes, and then I didn't have money for food. That's when I realized that I was in trouble. So I've learned to budget since then.
I had to pick one or the other.
네, 그래서 둘 다 살 돈은 없었기 때문에 앞에서 문장에서는 이제 사실 I didn't have any money라고 했지만 이제 이걸 더 살리기 위해서는 I didn't have enough,
enough.
money 그런 의미로 말한 것 같아요. 충분한 돈은 없었어요. 그래서 I had to pick one or the other.
The other.
여기서 one은 아마도 food,
food.
the other는
clothes.
둘 중에 하나를 골라야 했습니다.
Which one did she pick? She says, and I bought clothes and then I didn't have money for food.
그래서 돈은 이제 제한적인데 옷을 산 거예요, 먼저. 그랬더니 and then I didn't have money for food. 밥 먹을 돈이 없었던 거죠. 음식 살 돈이 없었어요. 그때서야
so she realized That's when I realized that I was in trouble. So I've learned to budget since then.
I feel like it was a little too late that you realized. 너무 늦게 깨달았을 수도 있지만 아무튼 uh-huh. 깨달았습니다. That's when I realized that I was in trouble. Uh-huh. 문제가 생겼구나라는 걸 그때서야 깨달았고요. Uh-huh. So I've learned to budget since then. Uh-huh. 그때 이후로 예산을 짜는 법을 배웠습니다. 여기 learned의 그 과거분사, learn의 과거분사죠. Uh-huh. 두 가지 스펠링이 있습니다.
Yeah.
미국에서는 보통 이렇게 안 쓰죠.
Yeah, in America we usually don't do it like that. We just say, you know,
learned.
네, but in sometimes in Australia and in the UK they'll say learnt.
Learnt 이렇게 T를
with a T
씁니다.
Instead of ED.
Yeah.
Perfect. Right. How about we review and take a look at our clip once again?
I actually used to be terrible when it came to saving money. I would just spend money all the time because I thought, well, it doesn't matter because I'm going to get paid next week and I'll just make the money back. So anytime I got paid, I'd go shopping. And because I was living at home, I didn't have to pay rent or anything. I would just buy whatever I wanted. I'd eat all the food I wanted. And it was really fun until I moved out of home and I started having to pay rent. And then I just had to learn how to budget my money. And that was a really stressful experience because at the same time, I had to pay rent now, but I was still trying to live this lifestyle where I was buying all the clothes I wanted and eating all the food I was eating. And it wasn't until I actually had to go shopping one day and I didn't have any money to buy food and clothes. I had to pick one or the other, and I bought clothes and then I didn't have money for food. That's when I realized that I was in trouble. So I've learned to budget since then.